Wall Street's woes have Main Street wondering, what happened? How do institutions so old and once so respected fall so dramatically and suddenly?
You know, I have one word for you. Greed. Regulators, congressmen, CEOs, investors, borrowers, lenders, we all got too greedy. We went to that frat party, we partied our butts off, and now we're paying the price, and this is a big hangover.
In other words, financial advisor Jill Schlesinger says too many loans were given and too many loans were taken. Everyone thought home prices would rise forever. They didn't, leaving the worst housing crisis since the Great Depression, a battered market, and as Smart Money magazine writer Russell Pearlman has seen, plenty of fear.
A lot of people scared right now, saying, should I pull the money out of my 401k or other investments? Your answer to that is what?
The biggest thing, don't panic. As bad as things look today, they're just going to be a blip on the market radar 10, 20 years from now.
Is it worth it all suspending the paycheck deductions?
Absolutely not. Absolutely. I'm sorry to cut you off, but you know what? Yeah. Absolutely not. This is the time where you should be putting more money in it.
Schlesinger says, think about it this way. You get something on sale, a 20% discount from where the market was last year. But what if you need money today?
How tough is it to get a loan right now, especially if you want to buy a home?
It's extremely tough right now. The good news is crunches like this don't last forever. So if you can afford to wait on getting any sort of loan, whether it's a car loan or a home loan, wait, because odds are in a few months it will be easier and most likely cheaper to get that type of loan.
Another big question is, when will all of this be over? There's a growing consensus on Wall Street today that this past weekend may have been the worst of it. That said, Katie, it will likely still be well into next year before the economy's fully back on track. Katie?
Jeff Glor. Jeff, thanks very much.